All right, so now that we have a set made, we've changed our tempo, how do we actually get the audio out of our computer into our sound system? So let's just talk about the basic and easy way to do this. If your device has a headphone jack on it, you can use your headphone jack and plug it into your sound system. Now, many people think, well, but how does that work? Because my headphone jack is only one jack, so it only has one output. But actually, your headphone jack has two outputs. It has the left side and it has the right side. Kind of like when you wear headphones, right? There's the left side and the right side. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna use that to our advantage, and we're gonna send the click and our band cues, the verse, two, three, four, we're gonna send all of that panned to the left side. And then all of our tracks are gonna be panned to the right side. Let me show you a really simple diagram. We have this at Loop Community if you ever need it. We're gonna come out of our device, whether it's an iPad or your laptop, come out of your headphone cable, headphone jack, and all you need is this little cable. This is like $5 probably on Amazon. And it takes your headphone jack and splits it into 2 quarter-inch sends. So we got the left side and the right side. And they're gonna go into 2 different DIs, direct boxes. And these are what you would maybe plug a guitar into or a keyboard. And then those direct boxes are gonna go to your sound system. So one of those direct boxes is gonna be for the click and the cue, it's the left side. And the tracks are gonna go into a DI, that's the right side. And you send that to your sound system and have your sound guy crank it. You wanna really start thinking about tracks and your computer being another instrument in your band. So have your sound guy turn it up. The click and cue, you gotta get to your band somehow so they can all hear it. If you have an in-ear monitor system, that's the best way. So how do we actually do audio routing inside of Ableton Live? All you do is in the bottom right corner, there's a little button that says I/O. I/O stands for in and out. When you click that, it opens up the in and out settings for every single channel in Ableton Live. And it looks a little confusing, but it's pretty simple. The top two white boxes, these are your audio input settings. If we were talking about how to record into Ableton Live, then those would be really important. But for this case, we're not doing that. We're looking for where are we sending the audio to? And that's where the bottom boxes come into play. So right now it says that every single one of my tracks is going to the master. Your master is over here on the right-hand side. And this is the master fader. Right now it says that the master is going out outputs 1 and 2. And this is where you just need to remember that 1 is left and 2 is right. So all of my tracks are going to the master, which is going out 1 and 2. Let's go ahead and change a few things. So the cues on this track, I'm gonna change this from the master to EXT out, which stands for external out, my headphone jack. I'm gonna change that to 1, which is left. Then I could go through every single one of my instruments and change this to 2, which would mean that they're all now all my instruments are going at output 2. But honestly, just for a shortcut, instead of doing that, I'm gonna keep all of those going to the master, and I'm gonna change the master to 2. Now your metronome goes out what's called Q out. Just something you have to remember. So Q out, I'm gonna change that to 1. So the breakdown of my audio routing here is that my cues are going out output 1, my click is going out output 1, which is the left side, and then all of my tracks are going to the master, which is going out output 2. So now if I plugged in a headphone cable into my computer, I would hear my click and cues on the left side, my tracks on the right. That's basic audio routing in Ableton Live.